It's gonna be okay, do you understand?
One.
You listen to me. I got exactly what you asked for. Did you want something else? If there was a misunderstanding, I will fix it. I can get it. Whatever you want.
Two.
Listen. Talk to me. We can talk. Like, gentlemen.
Three.
Yeah. I'm Ethan, your real life English fluency coach, and I'm excited because today we're learning English with another Ethan, with Ethan Hunt, the main character from the dynamic movies Mission Impossible. Now, I have a fun fact for you before we get started. Did you know that the actor Tom Cruise usually performs his own stunts? It's true. He's done things like hanging off the side of planes, climbing skyscrapers, and dynamic car chases. It's incredible, right? Well, if you would like to make learning English an epic mission every single week, then I have a mission for you. Hit that subscribe button and the bell down below, and that way you won't miss another one of our fun English learning lessons, and we can help you to understand fast-speaking natives without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles, so you can truly enjoy your favorite series, movies, music, and more. Are you ready? Let's get started. In most of the intense scenes from Mission Impossible 3, Ethan Hunt is questioning the notorious arms dealer, Owen Davian, to uncover the truth about the rabbit's foot, which is a dangerous weapon that has the potential to cause catastrophic destruction in the wrong hands. Let's watch.
You're dead, Mr. Davian. There are witnesses.
I was you in the bathroom.
And you're gonna tell us everything. Every buyer you've worked with, every organization.
What the hell is your name?
Names, contacts, inventory lists.
You have a wife, girlfriend?
It's up to you how this goes.
Because you know what I'm gonna do next? I'm gonna find her. Whoever she is, I'm gonna find her and I'm gonna hurt her.
You were apprehended carrying details of the location of something codenamed the Rabbit's Foot.
I'm gonna make her bleed and cry and call out your name. And you're not gonna be able to do shit. You know why?
What is a Rabbit's Foot?
Because you're gonna be this close to dead.
And who is the buyer?
And then I'm gonna kill you right in front of her.
I'm gonna ask you one more time.
What's your name?
What is a Rabbit's Foot?
Who are you?
And who's the buyer?
You don't have any idea what the hell's going on, do you? I mean, you saw what I did to your little blonde friend at the factory, right?
You're dead, Mr. Dave. There are witnesses.
That was you in the bathroom.
So Davian uses connected speech here. Notice that he uses a glottal T when pronouncing the T at the end of that. This means that the T sound isn't fully pronounced, and instead is cut off at the back of the throat. Let's practice it together. That was you.
That was you in the bathroom. That was you in the bathroom.
Every buyer you've worked with, every organization.
What the hell is your name?
Names, contacts, inventory.
Inventory means a collection of items that a person or business has, which includes all of the things that are available to be sold or used. So an inventory list is a detailed record of everything someone has, like products in a store, supplies in a warehouse, or even personal belongings in your home. Check out this example from the blacklist.
According to an inventory list, we're missing small arms, RPGs, 3 Hellfire missiles, plus over a ton of Semtex, C4, Demex, and Plastite.
Every organization.
What the hell is your name?
Names, contacts, inventory lists.
You have a wife, girlfriend.
Notice that when Davian says, you have a, he doesn't pronounce the H in have, av. The A is just pronounced as a schwa, and all three words link together. You have a. You have a. Listen again and repeat.
You have a wife, girlfriend.
lists.
Yeah,
it's up to you how this goes.
When something is up to you, the decision or responsibility is yours. So when Ethan uses the phrase, it's up to you how this goes, he implies that the final outcome of the situation depends only on Davian's decisions.
Because you know what I'm going to do next.
Here's another nice example of connected speech. Notice that the T at the end of what is pronounced as an American T, D sound. So we hear, what I'm. Remember that an American T occurs between two words when the first word ends with a T sound and the second word begins with a vowel sound. Davian also uses the reduced form of going to do, which is gonna do. Together this becomes, what I'm gonna do.
Because you know what I'm gonna do next.
Because you know what I'm gonna do next.
You were apprehended carrying details of the location of something codenamed the Rabbit's Foot.
When someone has been apprehended, it means they have been captured or arrested, usually because they are suspected of committing a crime or unlawful activity. For example, the suspects were apprehended while trying to run away from the police.
You were apprehended carrying details of the location of something codenamed the Rabbit's Foot.
Location is a versatile word which you can use to describe the position, place, or setting of something. For example, the restaurant is in a great location downtown.
You were apprehended carrying details of the location of something codenamed the Rabbit's Foot.
When something is codenamed, it means that it has been given a secret or alternate name. By giving something a codename, it ensures that only certain people know what you're actually referring to. Here's a fun example from Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
I had an informant on the inside. He's been here for years, watching, learning, waiting. His code name? Fuzzy Cuddle Bear.
I'm gonna make her bleed and cry and call out your name.
The phrase call out has different meanings depending on the context. Can you guess which of these clips shows the same meaning of call out as in the scene?
What are you, a cop? Call her out, Gary. I'm gonna need to see some ID.
Go get Sandy.
Prejudice is just ignorance, Kurt. And you have a chance right now to teach him.
How?
Confront him. Call him out.
Call out his name.
Call out his name!
Jumanji!
The answer is C.
Call out his name.
In clip A, when Jack Reacher says, call her out, he's asking that Gary literally get Sandy out from the back office and bring her to him as he'd like to speak with her. In clip B, to call someone out means to publicly confront or challenge them because of something they did or said. In clip C, to call out means to scream or shout something in order to get attention or as a sign of distress.
You're not gonna be able to do shit. You know why?
What is a rabbit's foot?
Because you're gonna be this close to dead.
And who is the buyer?
And then I'm gonna kill you right in front of her.
Do you know the difference between saying in front of her versus saying right in front of her? They seem similar. But in front of her describes the general location or position, but may not necessarily mean that the action happens close to her. By adding the word right, we create a strong emphasis on the location and suggest that the action being referred to happens directly and immediately in front of the person.
I'm gonna ask you one more time.
What's your name?
What is a rabbit's foot?
Who are you?
And who's the buyer?
You don't have any idea what the hell's going on, do you?
Here we have an example of a question tag, which are short phrases we add at the end of a sentence to make it sound like a question, and to ask for agreement or confirmation from the listener. They are a way to involve the listener in the conversation and encourage them to respond. Question tags can be positive or negative, depending on the statement. If the statement is positive, the question tag is usually negative. You like ice cream. You like ice cream, don't you? And if the statement is negative, the question tag is usually positive. For example, you don't like ice cream. You don't like ice cream, do you?
Now it can be difficult to remember the grammar rules when you don't actually have anyone to practice them with, right?
Well, with the Real Life English app, you never have to worry about this ever again. Now, the Real Life app is the only place where anytime, anywhere, you can simply press a button and instantly be connected to another English speaker in another part of the world for a fun and dynamic conversation in English. You can talk about your life, the things that you like to do in your free time, what you do for work, or anything else that occurs for you. And you can practice all that new vocabulary, pronunciation, grammar, and so much more that you're learning in these lessons and elsewhere in your life. It's really going to do wonders for helping you go from feeling like a lost, insecure English learner to being a confident, natural English speaker. So what are you waiting for? It's absolutely free to get started, so you can learn more by clicking up here or down in the description below now, or you can simply search for Real Life English in your favorite app store. See you there.
And you saw what I did to your little blonde friend at the factory, right?
A factory is an industrial facility or building where a large number of goods or products are made or manufactured. Check out this example from Friends.
That's why you got us tickets to that play, to get rid of us.
Yeah.
And the year before that, when you set up that nighttime tour of that button factory?
I can't believe you guys went for that one.
Did you notice how fast he said this? Americans will almost always say it this way. So let's practice it together. The key is this American T. It's actually pronounced like duh. Now the T at the end of it is pronounced as a glottal T, cut off at the back of the throat. It, it. The same thing happens in these words. Cat, foot, abort. All three words then link together so we hear, what is it? When Luther says, this isn't you, he means that the decision and action Ethan is about to take is negative and unusual for his character.
You have to stop. You have to stop denying who you are. It's boring. We can go anywhere. We can do anything. Let's go. Let's have some fun.
This isn't you. I know you. Where's the brother that I used to have?
We can use him, Ethan. You know that.
To use someone means to take advantage of them and benefit from them in some way. So when Luther says the phrase, we can use him, he reminds Ethan that Davian can be beneficial or useful to them in the future.
Talking about fixing time, Paul Mann's the key to all that. We finally have something that he wants. We can use him.
Use him for what?
Bait.
You're dead. Mr. Davy. There are witnesses.
That was you in the bathroom.
And you're gonna tell us everything. Every buyer you've worked with, every organization.
What the hell is your name?
Names, contacts, inventory lists.
You have a wife, girlfriend.
It's up to you how this goes.
Because you know what I'm gonna do next? I'm gonna find her, whoever she is. I'm gonna find her and I'm gonna hurt her.
You were apprehended carrying details of the location.
Which of these is a synonym for apprehended? Identified, seen, arrested?
Sounds something codenamed the Rabbit's Foot.
I'm gonna make her bleed and cry and call out your name. And you're not gonna be able to do shit. You know why?
What is a Rabbit's Foot?
Because you're gonna be this close to dead.
And who is the buyer?
And then I'm gonna kill you right in front of her.
I'm gonna ask you one more time.
What's your name?
What is a Rabbit's Foot?
Who are you?
And who's the buyer?
You don't have any idea what the hell's going on, do you?
Which of these question tag sentences are correct? They did finish their homework, have they? They have finished their homework, haven't they? They haven't finished their homework, haven't they?
Now you saw what I did to your little blonde friend at the factory, right? Well, that was nothing. That was fun. That's fun.
Ethan, what is the Rabbit's Foot? Ethan, stop! What is it? Don't do it! Ethan, what is the Rabbit's Foot? Help me! Ethan, stop! Don't do it! This isn't you, man! This isn't you! We can use them, Ethan! You know that!
To use someone means to take advantage of them, become friends with them, destroy them.
So if you enjoyed learning with Tom Cruise in Mission Impossible today, then next you definitely gotta check out our recent lesson with Top Gun. Let's check it out.
This is Coffin Corner. Assuming you avoid crashing into this mountain, you'll climb straight up into enemy radar while losing all of your airspeed. Within seconds, you'll be fired upon by enemy SAMs.
Sir, is this even achievable?
The answer to that question will come down to the pilot in the box.